Hey everybody, welcome back, and we're going to do a quick tutorial here. We've got some people in our community, which if you're not familiar with it, it is the Humanoid Nation on PlayStation Network, and that is a community featuring all old school content from 2001 all the way back to the dawn of the era in the industry. So if you're an old school wrestling fan, you might want to go ahead and check us out over there. Once again, that is the Humanoid Nation on the PlayStation Network community page. So in the meantime, we got to the point where there was just a lot of stuff being posted and it was kind of cluttering up the board and comments were being lost and things like that because of all the pictures being put up. So we've come up with a recent memorandum where we're asking everybody to stop posting a bunch of individual shots of things and start falling back on the collage features that you can get very simply out of Share Factory. So a couple of people maybe aren't as familiar with Share Factory as others. For a lot of you, this is going to be very old hat, but for some of you, you're going to learn some stuff that you didn't know before. So without any further ado, we're going to show you how to use Share Factory. And while we're going to be demonstrating on WWE 2K19, it'll work on absolutely anything you do on PlayStation. So the common thing that we normally see people posting are their created superstars, sometimes arenas, sometimes championship belts. For the purpose of this video, we're going to use the superstar feature, even though you can do it with anything. So we're going to go ahead and look at a custom superstar that I just did recently, and I have yet to post a collage for him. So we're going to do that right now, right here together. And that is going to be, as soon as they finish populating, there we go. Dustin Rhodes from back in his early WCW days. So we're just going to pop into the edit mode. We're not actually going to edit anything. He's pretty much done right now. The sad thing is, no matter which hair I used, his correct jacket will not cooperate with it. I think that's absolutely ludicrous, but is what it is. So what I'm going to do is go to the attire mode. Or I take that back. No, I'm not. I'm going to go to the screen mode. I'm going to just pop out there, and I'm going to kind of angle it around so I like what I see. And then I'm going to hold my options button down for 2 seconds. And that's going to take a snapshot right there. And then I'll just do a little bit of adjusting here, and same thing again there. This time, try again. We're going to go to the second version. And again, I'm going to use my left thumbstick so I can kind of freely transform him around a little bit. And again, I'll take a snapshot there. And this time we'll go with the jacket, even though I'm not going to actually do anything. I'm not going to save it. I'm just going to use it for the moment. And I think I'll use that as my close-up. All right, and then I'm just going to back out all the way because I'm not saving any of that. That was just for the purpose of taking some photographs, which we've now done. So we can actually close out the whole application. Boom, we're done. Now we're going to jump over to Share Factory. Share Factory is by far your best friend on PlayStation. You can do so much stuff with this. It is one of the greatest software editing free things you will ever get. It does quite a bit, this little thing does. You can create animated GIFs. I have not even taken advantage of that. It's good for all sorts of different platforms, social media, things of that nature. You can import stuff now with a USB drive. That was something you couldn't do not that long ago. But we're going to right now work on photographs. It's going to be a new project. And then the first thing you do is pick a theme. Now, for photographs, it's not as important, but what it will determine based on the theme you choose is what backgrounds you can choose. I personally like the Playroom theme because it's got that cool background right there, but we're not going to select it yet. So, in the meantime, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 photographs to work with. 1, 2, 4. Just hit the X button on all of them. And then when you're all done, as you can see in the lower section of the screen, it says add screenshots. Just hit the square button and it will add those 4 frames. And then you can either rename it or just continue. I always just continue because I'm not actually going to save any of this. All right. Now, right here, it's got 4 squares ready to go. But maybe I don't like that one. So I bounce over here to the right side, and then I can toggle with some other options. It'll still be 4 frames, but they'll be different. So I'll have one large size, and then it's kind of like having an 8x10 and 3 wallet size is the best way I can describe it. Or we could do something like that, or something like that. So it depends on what kind of photographs you have. Like if I had an actual in-ring event, this would probably be good, because then the bottom frame, I could get the whole ring into the picture. And this is another one. It's actually probably the one I think I'll go with. This is a pretty close to perfect for this project. So I'm going to take that, which means that these two guys are already pretty good. So as you highlight a photograph, you can do a number of things with it. As you see there, it says edit photo in the lower left corner. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to click on that. You can change the coloring around. You can do a bunch of different stuff. You can change a screenshot. If you don't want that one, you can flip them around. So let's say I want these two guys on the outside edges, but I want them reversed. So I can go to here, and I could switch it out with that, and then I can go over here and switch it out with the other one. But I actually do like it the way it was, so I'm going to stick with that. So again, I'll choose the screenshot, which is the one I want, which is, I believe, here, right? Yes. Now, from here, I can do something else by editing photo. I can skip over here to pan and zoom. This is your friend. Click on pan and zoom. So as you zoom in, then you can actually move the photograph around. And what is that good? Well, it lets you to cut off all this crap on the bottom. And then you can just get the subject matter. So you might zoom out a little bit or whatever, but size it the way you like it. When it's where you want it, click, and there it is. Same thing here with my close-up, pan and zoom. Gonna bring it in and click. And now all the text is gone. One more time over here, gonna pan and zoom. And I'm going to drop them down just a little bit lower. There we go. That's good right there. And then the last one down here in the bottom. Again, we're going to zoom. In that case, I might want to zoom out a little bit. I don't want the top of his head being cut off like that. There we go. So now the photograph part is pretty well done. What we're going to do now is edit the background. And for that, as you can see on the bottom, you're going to click the square button. You can choose the color of the background, you can choose the background, and then you can choose your border settings. I generally don't mess with the color. I go straight to the choose the background, and this is where I'm going to choose this photograph right here, your playroom art, as the background. Now, you can't really see it right now, but that's okay. You're going to see it a little bit better in a moment. Now, we're going to go back to that edit background button again, only this time we've already chose the background, so we don't need that. We're going to go to our border settings, and what that's going to do, we've got two different lines to work with, how far the pictures get spaced. So I'm going to increase that a bit, and now all of a sudden you can start seeing the background through it just enough to get those little colors kind of exploding through. All right, so I'll probably go to about 50, and then rounding, that's the edges on each photograph. You're going to put like a bit of a curve to the edges, and it just makes it kind of look nice and softens it a bit. And now we've got the final photograph. Now, options here is you could save it. I never do. All I do here is if you hit your left 2 trigger, boom, takes up the entire screen. I wait about 10 seconds for that little toolbar to disappear the way it just did. And now the only thing there is the screenshot. At this point, I would normally just take the picture by holding the options button for 2 seconds, and that's it. We're done. However, I did forget to put some text in here, and I want to do that. So, doesn't matter which frame you're on, really. You can be in any picture, but you want to go to Add Overlay. Now, from there, you can add any kind of these little stickers if you want to. You can pick up theme stickers, and you could add these guys in if you wanted to. So let's say we put Winning, and we can move him around by going to Transform, and then we could move him around anywhere in the picture we want. We could also make him smaller, and we can even rotate him. And then we hit the X button to kind of plant him in position. And then we back out by hitting the circle twice. And there he is. But in this case, what I want to do, I'll leave him there. He's not hurting nothing. Is I want to, wrong button, sorry. Edit photo again is a square button. We're going to edit overlays again. Only this time, we're going to go down to the text. depending on how much text you're going to use will determine which size of the font you want to choose. So I chose the large font because I'm just going to put a name, and it won't take up that much. So we're going to go with Dustin. Rhodes. Maybe it should be just Dustin now, like Cody's only going by Cody. All right, now we're going to select. You could check select the opacity if you want it to be somewhat transparent. I do not. We're going to go to our color palette. I generally just grab one of these bottom five, but you could be very precise by sliding it over on top. But then you also have to go with your saturation on bottom to actually get the color to come through. Otherwise, it'll all be pretty bland. So since we've gone this far, might as well go the rest of the way. We'll go with a hot pink that pops off the page a little bit. Then we're going to go to our text effects. And there's a whole bunch of different effects you can give the text. Everything from a steel finish to kind of a 3D etch. I like this one a lot for my created wrestler photos that I post. I think it pops nice. Then there's just a silly outline right there. There's another variation. And again, there's a whole mess of different ones down here as you go through. I don't really care for anything beyond the top five, with rare exception. Sometimes there's something that I can use some of these other textures for, but for me, this is pretty much my go-to. So we're going to go with Dustin Rhodes, going to save that. Then we got to go to transform because we have to move it, which is really what transform should say. Should say like locate because that's what you're doing with it. I'm going to save it right there. I'm going to back out by hitting circle twice again. And now one other thing I like to do, and I think it's a good idea, and that is to put my signature tag down so that they know how to find it. So as you should know, if you're looking for somebody's created work on the PlayStation Network for WWE 2K19, if you have a hashtag with a locator, it makes it much easier. So there's mine, One Nation, the number one in the word nation. And in this case, we're going to go to that colored pie again. Only this time I'm just going to grab that guy off the bottom. Boom. And then again, we're going to go to the effect, and I'm going to still use my go-to one because I like it. And then we're going to transform, and a number of things. Like, I mean, I could put him here, but then it's kind of cutting the head off. I don't want to do that. So I think what I'm going to do in this case is just rotate it and plant it right there. And then back out. And now, once again, I'm going to use my left two trigger, make it full screen, wait for that little bar to disappear on the bottom. There it goes. Now I'm going to hold my options button for 2 seconds. One, two. That sound means you took a picture. And now I'm done. I'm just going to shut it down. Close application. Not saving nothing. All gone. Now as I go over here to my capture gallery and I open my file and I go to my screenshots. There it is. Ready to go. What I'll also do is get rid of all the loose ones because I just don't like keeping a bunch of stuff laying around. And delete those. And then we want to post it. So let's go over here to community create or communities. And we'll bounce over here to the Humanoid Nation. And as you can see, we've got stuff. All right, so here's somebody posting one of their arenas. And this is what I'm talking about right here. When you put a collage together like this, you can get several different looks and images all in one nice, tight little area. It doesn't get repetitive and doesn't bundle things up and it doesn't lose our text. And again, this is kind of what we're trying to avoid. It's a good creation. There's nothing wrong with it. But when you start stacking four pictures, then some of the people's comments and discussions get lost in the mix, and it just gets busy. And here's another great example of how to use the collage effect. This was for in-ring action. It took place between DiBiase and Piper, and it almost tells the whole story, man. You can just look frame to frame to frame. You know who won. You know who lost. You see some of the highlights. See Piper spilling the blood. It's good stuff. I mean, this is really a much better... This is more effective than if somebody would have posted all those pictures individually, because quite honestly, it just turns people off, and it gets hard to deal with when there's that many pictures. So because we're trying to clean things up a little bit, and because a few people weren't so familiar with how SharePlay works, I said, let me do a quick video to show them. So now I'm going to grab that photograph, and I'm going to post it so they know that Dustin Rhodes is done, and he will be available if they want to download him. Okay, and then I can post a comment here if I want to, but really the picture says it all, so I'm good. And I'm just going to post it. And there it is, and then we can pull it up just to make sure everything looks good. Of course, why wouldn't it? And there you have it. So I hope this video has helped you guys out if you're not familiar with how SharePlay works and all the cool things you can do with it. And that's just doing photographs. I mean, it's so freaking cool what you can do with it with videos. Trust me. It's worth doing a bunch of tutorials, man. Look around. I've got tutorials on other channels that I also am part of. So you can do searches for Share Factory. If there's any questions you guys have specifically with Share Factory, feel free to put them in the comments down below. I'll be more than happy to either answer them or do a short video showing you exactly how to do whatever it is you're trying to do. All right, that is going to wrap this one up. I thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you real soon ringside. Have a great day.